In the end, Galaxy Watch is gonna feel like a Samsung Watch, but not really. And in this case, something tells me you'll love the changes made. Hi guys, Alina here. Welcome back to Need to Know. Next Wednesday, we're in for a treat. Samsung is doing its annual summer reveal, and this time we'll have 5 gadgets to check out. We've been over the Galaxy phones, but haven't really gone into the cool wearables the company is getting out. And folks, I gotta tell you, Samsung is finally getting us excited about their watches again. Galaxy Watch 3's got plenty to love. While the Watch Active showed Samsung can do slicker designs without giving in to peer pressure and go rectangular, it also disappointed. The trademark rotating bezel was out, and the watch lost some of its originality. Well, I'm happy to say Samsung changed their mind this year. Or, better said, you made them reconsider. Yes, this year's Galaxy Watch 3 will let you go through apps and features by rotating the crown left and right. And that's not all. As much as we appreciate the comeback, we're actually excited about the new gesture controls. And I don't think I'm the only one. Now, it's true, gesture controls have been hit and miss with phones, but here, they make total sense. After all, we're not talking about a device that you already have to hold and handle with one hand, and that's most of the time out of your reach. We're looking at a gadget that sits on your wrist at all times. So, what can you do without rotating the bezels or pushing the buttons? Silence alarms and annoying calls with just a simple twist of your wrist. Natural and convenient, I'd say. And when you want to snap a photo, record a video, or why not take a call, you simply clench or unclench your fist. Obviously, you won't trigger all 3 actions with your fist. It's up to you to choose just one of them. And yeah, it's gonna take a bit for people to realize that you're not anxious or ready to punch someone, but if you're generally pretty zen or you're not in the habit to show your stress levels that way, you should be fine. To me, this feels intuitive and makes total sense. Galaxy Watch 3 really feels like a mature smartwatch. After a lot of trial and error, Samsung has finally found users' sweet spot. Watch 3 has the user experience that caters to anyone and everyone. Buttons, rotating bezel, hand gestures. And I could see this idea carried on throughout the product. First, you've got 2 sizes to choose from. A 45mm with a 1.4-inch display and a 41mm with a 1.2-inch display for smaller wrists. There's LTE and Wi-Fi options depending on how much you use it day by day. Storage and memory should be enough in all the situations you can think of. You've got 1GB of RAM and 8 of storage with a 340mAh battery on the bigger model. Water resistance is nothing new. You can take it underwater up to 50 meters for 10 minutes. Heart rate and ECG monitoring are in, as well as blood pressure. Yay! It was about time! It's 2020, so of course we've got female health tracking and, happy to say, caffeine intake. That, right there, is what I absolutely should measure, although I'm kind of scared of the results. And if you're someone who hates being stuck in a rut, good news! You get to customize a lot of things this time around, like the size of your font, icons, and other types of content. There's also Color Lens, Samsung's way to help out with the eye strain. On a display like this one, your eyes are definitely giving their all to read notifications, email, so that's a welcome feature. Talking about email, Outlook is taking over. Don't say we didn't tell you. Spotify will come as a pre-installed app, and I'm told you'll also spot a new music app from Samsung. If you care about the interface as much as I do, you'll appreciate the revamped watch faces. Yeah, you'll get new models too, but most importantly, stats will be displayed differently alongside the watch bezel. In the end, it's gonna feel like a Samsung watch, but not really, and in this case, something tells me you'll love the changes made. When is the smartwatch coming out officially? Well, Samsung is going to show it off on August 5 during the Unpacked event, so you'll know for sure then. My advice? Tune in to see how the Note 20 compares to last year's and check out the Fold 2. These two might have something in common. Oh, and yes, definitely look for the Galaxy Buds Live. They're too cute to pass. The bean shape is not everyone's first choice, but I'm all in. unless it falls right out, and then I'll be the first one to say usability over cuteness. Until then, let me know if the Galaxy Watch 3 checks all your boxes or if there's something Samsung missed. Oh, and don't forget, subscribe and hit the bell button if you want to see more videos like this. Stay safe, guys!